Good evening, everybody. Thank you all for coming out. I'm Joey Barron. I'm the co-founder and executive director of the Boston Jewish Music Festival, who were honored to be asked by the Elie Wiesel Center at Boston University to produce this incredible event. So I'm just going to be very brief for an unusual opportunity. Thank you all for coming out. This is, we all need moments of harmony, and this is a night of harmony in the greatest sense of the word. It's also, we were scheduled to have Bob Oakes from WBUR do a special introduction and narration. Luckily, I'm not going to do it, but unluckily, Bob was hospitalized last night and was kind enough to arrange for somebody else to take his place. So please join me in welcoming Carrie Goldenberg from WBUR, who is tonight playing the part of Bob Oakes. So thank you all for coming.
Thank you, Joey. Thank you. Thank you, and welcome to the Quill of the Soul. Legend has it that the Rebbe of Kalev, the Kalever Tzaddik, was once walking in the forest when he heard a shepherd singing a love song in Ukrainian. The Hasid was captivated by the song, whose lyrics spoke of the shepherd's longing for his beloved, who was separated from him. The Rebbe of Kalev took the song and replaced the lyrics with a description of a soul longing for the Shekhinah, the mystical divine presence. He then asked the shepherd to sing the song, but the young man found that he had forgotten it, whereupon the Hasid exclaimed, "I have purified the nigun, the chant, and returned it to its holy sources." Elie Wiesel, in his memoirs, which were titled All Rivers Run to the Sea, says, "My grandfather knew the romantic, mystical songs of the Rebbe of Kalev." And Wiesel writes, "And how alive he was, my grandfather, alive and magnificent. He was a marvelous singer with a warm, melodious voice that could conjure worlds near and far. When he stopped singing to catch his breath, I would beg him for more, and with an ever more gleeful smile, he would recall a new song attributed to this or that tzaddik. Once he stopped in the middle of a nigun. Eyes closed, he seemed asleep. Afraid of waking him, I didn't budge. But he wasn't sleeping. 'I'm dreaming,' he said. 'I've never sung so much. Thanks to you, I think I can rise to the celestial sanctuary where words become song.'" The Jewish people are the people of the book. And who's more fitting to testify to that than Elie Wiesel, the world-renowned author, scholar, human rights advocate, Nobel laureate, and Boston University professor emeritus. Wiesel is not commonly known for his passion for music. But this changed when, on December 18th, 2010, he decided to share memories and melodies that helped shape his soul at a special concert at the 92nd Street Y in New York. As the founder of Chabad said, "The tongue is the pen of the heart, but melody is the quill of the soul." Quill of the Soul, the final concert in Mátti Kovler's Floating Tower series at Boston University, is a musical tribute to Elie Wiesel, inspired by the work of the Israeli composer and Kovler's mentor, Andre Haidu. Haidu may be a name less familiar to American audiences. A pupil of Zoltan Kodály and Olivier Messiaen, Haidu is considered to be the Béla Bartók of Hasidic music. Born in Europe 3 years apart, both Haidu and Wiesel are members of the same generation. Wiesel collected, adapted, and taught Hasidic tales, while Haidu collected, adapted, and taught nigunim, Hasidic melodies. According to Professor Michael Zonk, director of the Elie Wiesel Center, Wiesel students came from every school, not just literature or music, but from across the spectrum. Wiesel, a mesmerizing storyteller, does not teach Hasidic tales as Jewish texts, but as literature with universal human concerns, with themes of memory and issues of moral choice. Haidu integrates Jewish folk nigunim and instrumental music from Eastern Europe into a broader genre of contemporary art music. Through his work with his students in Israel, and four of those students are on this stage tonight, Yair Harel, Yonatan Niv, Nori Jacobi, and Mátti Kovler, Haidu encourages a stylistic diversity, which allows for Sephardic musical inspirations to coexist alongside Gershwin or Bartok style arrangements. This approach manifested itself in the Israeli production of Kulmuth HaNefesh, or Quill of the Soul, where Haidu and students performed original arrangements to Hasidic niguns. Although the Jewish tradition always gave its unique flavor in their work, each in their own way, both Haidu and Wiesel found ways to communicate world culture. Tonight, we invite you to join us on a journey where the Hasidic nigun finds its comparatives from melody to language, from Ukrainian to Persian, from Yiddish to Sanskrit. A journey that reflects a world in which tunes can begin as sacred and then go through the secular world, changing geography and language, but always coming back to the basic human need of expressing the soul. In his Hasidic tales, Elie Wiesel tells us of another rabbi, Rebbe Uri of Strelitz. He says, legend has it that Rebbe Uri of Strelitz, through his prayers, acquired such powers that he could obtain for his people anything they desired. Therefore, each morning before services, he would make mental notes of the requests he was to present in heaven. However, as soon as he began to pray, his soul caught fire, and in his ecstasy, he forgot what it was he had planned to ask. We invite you to forget the boundaries of language and style and immerse yourself in this celestial sanctuary where the soul's longing becomes song.